Good evening, everybody. I know it's a little dark. I'm on my way upstairs. I just finished working for a client, so I'm gonna go ahead and get some work on unpacking and bring you all with the unpacking work we're gonna be doing today, everybody. The one space all of you are like, that's not the first place they put together? Seriously? We're gonna go ahead and finish fully putting together the coffee bar appropriately with some help if needed. Let's get started. Welcome back, everybody. As you can tell, we've just been kind of piecemeal using our coffee container. So let's go ahead and set this up to do a rinse for the day. I gotta take trash out and all that jazz here later. So bum, ba, da, da, a little bit of Dawn in there. A little bit of hot water in there and let that soak. I don't really ever scrub it. I just let it soak overnight and then give it a run with a brush in the morning and rinse when I use it. So let that go there. Hi, baby girl. Hi, baby girl. Alrighty. So, let's go ahead and see what all we've got here. I need to make room for hanging these items. So let's sit them aside here with ornaments. Yes, we'll go over Christmas tree decorating in an upcoming video. Did you miss me or something today? Morale. Morale. As you can tell, we have multiple children saying hello. So let me check and see. This mug needs cleaned. good mug, if you ask me. One of my faves. And I think this mug was also used. So let me go ahead and put these over in the sink to get run through the dishwasher with the dishes later. Somebody asked if I would do an update on my morning and my evening routine. Maybe once the new year is here, okay? So some of you are probably wondering, where'd the kitty cat come from? This is a replica of a kitty cat named Ryo, who passed away a couple years ago. A friend of mine in high school painted this to match him. It was in our bathroom at the old place, but I think I'll just leave him out here. This Feliway needs thrown away. I'll slip that in my pocket to take care of it later. We have a little bit of tea from when I was sick. Cat treats can go with the cat toys that got locked in that box. I know you want some. You can't have any right now. Maybe later. As you can all tell, things are a little topsy-turvy here still. So what's in the box? What's in the box? Let's see here. We have, sorry about that. We have a couple, excuse you, odds and ends here. These, I think, were meant to go in the lunch caddy. Kitchen stuff got thrown in here. And we do still have this from Valentine's Day that kind of got plopped up here and never used, which is okay. So what else do we have? What else do we have here? Hello. Hello. Apparently it is going to be treats time here soon. So, gave another basket of stuff, and it apparently did also. Why are all of our chopsticks, like, randomly in here? That doesn't make any sense. Sensing no making! Sensing no making! Alright, so let's go ahead and get all of the chopsticks out of there. I think that's all of them. Alright, and if not, we'll come back. We'll come back. Alright, so let's set those aside. Okay. So, let's see. That's probably going to be sorted as trash. Because I don't know if those napkins were exposed to anything. I'm not sure what that's to. This is our straw caddy. And you can tell what we're a fan of for coffee around here. Top of the morning. I kid you not. It is the drink of this house. Some of you are like, wait a minute. Isn't that YouTuber gamer Jacksepticeye's coffee? Yes, and I wholly and thoroughly endorse, like, that's the only coffee that Cody and I can agree on enough to go ahead and actually share it. He's not the biggest coffee drinker. I need to get a separator for all my teas here. He's not the biggest coffee drinker. So, whatever he will enjoy, I will try to get him to enjoy it with me. So, not sure what that coffee lid goes to. Set that aside. We have some loose teas and things, and then there's our actual coffee. So this must have been what we were using as tea caddy for now. I need an actual, like, legit tea caddy. I need an actual legit tea caddy. So, let's see. What mugs be in here? I'm surprised any were left in here during the move. I love this mug. It's one of my faves. One of my faves. What else is in here? This is a plain Jane that's probably being gotten rid of. I got this one during our vow renewal in Williamsburg, Virginia. So that was from that trip. What's in the next drawer down? Nothing yet. And then there's, like, all of our, where things like this probably live. For that. And then are these supplies still? Okay, that's our cheese plate, which I gotta put the other plate there. There's our extra, like, Swiss Miss and Kool-Aid stuff. And then extra tea and stuff. So I have a lot of organization of the tea things to organize, but yeah, and if I say organize one more time, I guess you're going to have to take a drink of your coffee or tea of choice, huh? That wasn't quite the point of the video. Let's go ahead, though, and look at more of the mug collection and see what's in here. Cat entertainment, apparently. Not a feather boa. This is not Lola. No, my cats are not show girls. You're not a show girl, are you? Maybe that's why they're staying up so late at night. Anyway, more chopsticks that I'll take out. I like to keep candy in this jar here. Right now we have some of my old favorites, these little strawberry candies. I used to keep them in my candy jar for incentives at school because kids would literally fight over the little grandma candy dish strawberry candies, kid you not. Obviously, I gotta clean my items that are in here. I'm not sure why we have a cork. Oh, that's the cork from the coffee-flavored mead that Cody's mother had given us as a housewarming present for our apartment when we moved in a year ago. And I think my tea-infusing kitty cat can also sit there for a little bit. And that's a straw topper. I'm not even sure where I got that. So leave those to sit there. And get their cleaning on. Whoops. Sorry about that. Oh, let's see, what other mugs do we have in here? Well, this one makes sense. Cheesecake Man sounds like a Wookiee. On cue, just saying. He can literally talk like a Wookiee. And we have this mug. Till Death Star do us part, ha ha ha. And of course, you gotta have the Stormtrooper. To go with as well. So I'll probably put those in together. We have quite the impressive little collection of nerdy Star Wars glasses for Cody. I have a Totoro, 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 Totoro mug, and of course a ton of writerly mugs like writer's block, when your imaginary friends stop talking to you. I'm looking at you, Frey. I'm looking at you. I don't even care if your work here is done yet, dude. It's all your fault. Go read book 3. It's up on Ream Stories, The Myrna Annals, Bound by Vengeance and Mind. Keep calm. It's only a first draft. Oh boy, is it. This is my NaNoWriMo mug, basically, whenever I am stuck, because this is what we all want to be, as a future best-selling author, and why not? You can tell that there's a preference for writerly mugs here, including my own. This one was part of the first run of the Rebirth collection. No, this design is no longer available. Maybe next year. Maybe next year. So what if it started as a fan fiction? I mean, we all want this fan fiction, don't we? I'm sure one day there's going to be Disco Chad fan fiction. Mel, sorry, not sorry. Inca, you're welcome. Anyway, because let's get real. If anyone were to start writing Disco Chad fan fiction, if it's not me... It's not me, it's probably Inca York. I'm looking at you, kid. Go check out her ream. I mean it. Description box below. Anywho, we are at an impasse. I need sharp objects. Let's go find sharp objects. Much to the YouTube algorithm's dismay, I'm going to have to show some sellotape. I see you, my fellow authors who are from the UK. Some sellotape. Some packaging tape. I think a butter knife will do. I hope a butter knife will do. Lord knows I have daggers somewhere. Not just in my glare, like said Okaiba. Anyway. Butter knife. Don't fail me now. You used to help me repair Nintendos and stuff. Come on. Yay! And I also consequently found our alcohol. So apparently that's our adult-only drinks. That's not coffee mug stuff. There was another coffee mug box around here somewhere. I thought so. I know I got rid of a couple, but I didn't think I got rid of that many. There's also our pillows in there. Knife in the round. I'm going to need it for the coffee cups. Anyway, so welcome back, everybody. Welcome back, everybody. Excuse you. What do you think you are doing? Down. I have video evidence this time. Down. Oh my goodness. Christmas trees and pika kitties. Do not mix, let me tell ya. Christmas trees and pika kitties. Do not mix. Anywho, here's the rest of our coffee mug collection that I apparently took better care to wrap up. So, paper in the kitchen, there it goes. Let's see. Oh, our holiday mugs. We're gonna want those here soon. Cody and I had, I'm not even sure where Cody or me or my mother or whomever got these mugs from. But I think the pair of them need to sit out because, well, tis time of year appropriate. And as you can see, they have much wear, tear, and love. I know there is another set, scoochie scoochie, in here. There they are. Dashing through the snow. Also has to go out and let those sit there together. Oof, I gotta really clean this place up. Give you all a little bit of a before and after. Two of my favorite mugs, also from our vow renewal trip. Life is indeed often better at the beach. And let's get real. I'm from Maryland. This is just accurate. Crabby until I get my coffee. I'm from Maryland. That's just accurate. Because, yeah, crabs. Anyway, not the kind you eat, guys. The kind you eat. Don't be rude and gross. Jeez. I think I... Oh, Cody's, Yeah, this was obviously a misprint mug. It's why we paid like $1 for it when we bought it. Because it's, in our opinion, printed upside down. More trash. We have Make Today Awesome. This used to sit in my classroom and was one of the two coffee mugs I used all the time when I was teaching alongside my I Love Cats and my Totoro mug. Those three basically lived in my classroom for a couple of years. Whoops. Well, it has more character now, just like me. Oh well. Dang it. At least that's all that happened. At least it's all that happened is a tiny chip. I also have not just a Raita, an author tuba. As well, thank you, Eva, Bookin' Lane. Bush Gardens, I got this years ago at a family vacation. And then there's Cody's Port Sky from when he was in college. That's the cafe he worked at. And he, I don't know if that was like one he purchased or like an employee gift. And then the last item to unbox that is coffee related. This is mine. When I put out my first book, this was my present to me. And we're talking about when I put out the original version of Bound by Fate and Blood. It's a soda can shape on the bottom. I think it's 30 ounces, 24 maybe. One of my favorite items. I don't use it that much because it's resin coated and I don't want the resin to crack. So I use it on occasion, but I think it's time to do a little bit of a before and after sweep of the table. So, a before. Oh, I think we got to make this look a little bit cleaner, a little bit more holiday jazzy. 3, 2, 1. Looking a lot better, looking a lot better, looking a lot better. Got a touch of Christmas going on. Got a touch of Christmas going on. Including our little cafes ready to go. So we're all restocked. I ended up keeping that little mug that I said might get thrifted out to hold some tea, so it's still getting used. Yay! And I think we're ready for an entire Christmas season, an entire winter of hot beverages. I think you can tell we need to get the cold beverages going, but we kind of need to finish unpacking and reorganizing the house first. So thank you for joining me as I go ahead and set up the rest of our coffee station and kind of re-inventory our mugs a little bit.
If you want to go ahead and get together for a coaching session, or if you're looking for some post-NaNoWriMo editing, don't forget to check me out at my website, www.jennathesoulwriter.com. And of course, the Myrna Annals, dude, we're gearing up for a Kickstarter number 2 in the spring. Let's rock it. Thank you all for being here. Happy holidays. And of course, you better be taking care of yourself. You've been worth it all along.